Hello everyone and welcome back to Melee Friday. It is time to have a look at the next melee weapon, this time it will be the bow. The bow is a staff weapon for mastery rank 0. It has a fairly high range and deals primarily impact damage at an average attack speed. You can get the blueprint for the bow on the market for 15,000 credits and build it for an extra 15,000 credits, 1 Orokin cell, 900 savage, 600 ferrite and 150 alloy plates. The Orokin cell aside maybe, that makes it a fairly cheap to build weapon. Let's look at this melee weapon in game. Without a stance, the bow has a fairly slow 4 hit combo as well as a charge attack that will knock your enemies down. While this default combo looks cool, it is unfortunately much more efficient to just do quick attacks with the staff while you have a ranged weapon drawn. Because those quick attacks are a lot faster even if you have a stance equipped on the staff and they will also stagger your enemy with each hit. They don't look anywhere near as cool though. So against the level 10 corpus, the staff performs rather well. The range generally is fairly forgiving with your swings and slide attacks so that you do not need to aim too well at anyone to hit them. Corpus generally won't be able to do too much against you when you are this close to them, just watch for the fire of the other nearby corpus while you are exposed to them. Facing the infested, you need to watch that you do not get swarmed by them when you have the staff drawn. You can handle normal enemies just fine, but Eximus enemies will be a problem when there's more than one of them. When a healer is around, enemies are rather tough to kill, which generally makes this weapon not a great choice against infested and endless missions on lower levels. For the Grineer, the bow is actually rather good. Normal troopers only take a couple hits, sometimes even only one single charge attack. Only the heavy Grineer can take some time to bring them down, and you are best off with just knocking them down with ground slams and heavy melees to make sure that they cannot attack you. To be prepared for the level 30 enemies, I added a rank 5 Northwind in the depolarity slot, a rank 5 pressure point and a rank 5 molten impact for increased general damage and extra blast damage. With the remaining capacity, I was able to fit in a rank 0 reach mod for a bit of extra range. When you face a corpus at this level, you will see much better results than before. Normal enemies go down fast and when you have a combo in front of you, you can just keep hitting them to stagger them continuously. If you want to make it really quick, just spam the quick attack even though it does not look as great as a combo. Against the infested you won't have much trouble anymore. Once a couple mods are installed in the bow, you will kill the standard enemies with only a few hits or a single charged attack. The slide spin attack can also deal heavy damage to them. The bow is actually surprisingly good against the Grineer at this level, considering that the damage types I have are not ideal against them. You only need a couple of hits for the standard troops and if you run into any trouble, you can dispose of even smaller groups with a few swings, since you can hit multiple enemies at once thanks to the range of the staff. Against the heavy enemies it certainly helps that you will stagger them with each hit. So let's come to the final assessment of the staff. It may not be ideal for all situations, but overall the bow is a good weapon, especially for its low resource costs. For low mastery rank players, I would definitely recommend this weapon since it is still good in high level missions. The fact that each hit staggers the enemy certainly helps in a lot of situations and with a quick attack you can stunlock pretty much everyone except a few stagger resistance enemies like bosses. As many other weapons though, the bow has a prime variant available that is much better than the normal one. So if you like fighting with it, I recommend to not put a catalyst in it and rather try to get your hands on the bow prime. Just bear in mind that the Prime version requires you to have Mastery Rank 5. Thank you all for watching and I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give me a thumbs up and leave a comment if you like, and if you did not like it and you wish me to hell, well, give me a thumbs down then. This was me, Drenon, with a look at the bow. I hope that I will see all of you again next time. Bye!